TSM is a renowned organ team, but their strategy isn't anything wild. The difference is how they play it and how they can adapt to different team strategies. When you look at the positioning of each player, you'll notice that Smoke and Mute are holding Laundry and Freezer with their shotguns, while Mai is doing a bunker hold, and Echo is playing at Elbow so that he can support Ramai in bunker while still being able to watch site. And you'll notice Jaeger is at rear stage. Despite Jaeger being positioned here, this is a full anchor strat, and you'll soon see why. The first thing I'm going to focus on is the Jaeger. The reason he's playing around rear stage alone is because it's extremely easy to destroy a drone and fall back to site. This forces the attackers to re-drone tower, rear stage, and back stairs in order to make sure the area is clear. And as you may notice, teams will always clear big tower and rear stage if they're going for a bunker push. Without this control, the push is very linear. The attackers can't do much. They can't really get electrical or pillar control, and so they wouldn't be able to go for an execute. They wouldn't be able to push onto site. Now, when Jaeger falls down back stairs, he plays around pillar where he can support and be supported by Mai extremely easily, especially with lines of sight into bunker from pillar. TSM also sometimes brings out this angle, which makes it possible for a site player to watch the back stairs. Once Jaeger is at pillar, his main goal is to hold the position as long as possible. Well, Mai's life relies on holding pillar control, because without it, he just gets shot in the back. Well, Mai has nowhere to go if the attackers are both pushing bunker back and back stairs at the same time. Well, Mai cannot retreat, and so he's essentially playing his life. But what if the attackers push Laundry? Well, it's actually pretty easy for TSM, especially with their setup. With Mute and Smoke playing close on the Laundry and Freezer stairs, it's very difficult to push them out of their positions, unless you get the hatches. But if Kaid is on the board, you can actually make an indestructible Electroclaw on Freezer Hatch. So if Maverick and Thatcher are banned and Kaid's on the table, Freezer Hatch is impossible to open. This completely destroys any Laundry and Freezer push, because they rely on opening hatches in order to get Laundry and Freezer control. So Tempo Storm, when they realize this, try to push bunker and completely blunder their attack. With less than a minute left, they try to completely redirect their attack for a bunker Laundry push, which results in the attackers getting picked off one by one as they try to charge into site without intel. For Smoke, he'll fall back to Laundry so that he can support Mute and Freezer and still watch Laundry. Another benefit of this is that he can smoke out both Freezer and Laundry from his position. If Mute loses Freezer Hatch, he has two options: fall back or go for a trade. With the hatch open, Mute immediately loses a lot of space to walk in. So normally you're going to want to fall back and just give up Freezer, because you can still hold a lot of cross angles on it. However, Mute can actually walk up the stairs and try to go for a trade, and it can catch the attackers by surprise. This is a strategy that's only going to work one time, but it can be a good one. But anyway, TSM sets themselves up extremely well in accordance to each other when it comes to watching what needs to be watched, and also when it comes to making refrags. While Oregon's already a very defender-sided map, they set up crossfires and maneuver around in a way that not a lot of teams do. And although if you watched the August Major, you may have noticed that Dark Zero beat TSM on Oregon. While TSM only played basement once in that game, they won the round because Bolo clutched. So what went wrong? Well, TSM had split themselves up where they couldn't play off of each other or get refrags. This allows the attackers to take pillar control and continue pushing into site despite the round still being a 5v5 with 25 seconds left. Mew and Mira had also gotten clumped up together in supply and were in horrible position to prevent plant. Mew had also missed an opportunity to save Mira's life and make the retake much easier. However, despite this, Bolo still clutched around and won. And although I originally praised TSM for their good positioning, in this round it was weak and it showed with how close the round was. Because normally, TSM should never win that situation. Their positioning was horrible. And if you learned something, give the video a like, and if you want to see more content like this, then subscribe. Toodles.